Today's study is out of the book of James in chapter 3, verse 13 through 18. Let's read it. Who is wise and understanding among you? Let them show it by their good life, by deeds done in the humility that comes from wisdom. But if you harbor bitter envy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not boast about it or deny the truth. Such wisdom does not come down from heaven, but is earthly, unspiritual, and demonic. For where you have envy and selfish ambition, there you find disorder and every evil practice. But the wisdom that comes from heaven is first of all pure, then peace-loving, considerate, submissive, full of mercy and good fruit, impartial and sincere. Peacemakers who sow in peace reap a harvest of righteousness. We live in a valley full of agriculture. We grow everything from tree fruit to hay, alfalfa, hops, potatoes, and hundreds of other fruits and vegetables. It's one of my favorite things about living in the Yakima Valley. Now, I was born and raised in an agricultural community. And one of the things that I learned really early on in my life is that the right weather is critical for crops to grow successfully in order to have a good harvest. If it was too windy, you couldn't spray the necessary fertilizers or chemicals on fields. If hay was cut and it was down, and then the rain came, it could ruin an entire harvest of hay. If a small little bug or worm got into an orchard of tree fruit, it could ruin the entire crop. The right environment and the right climate are critical in order for things to grow. And in this passage, James is asking the teachers of the day a question. And it's a setup for an explanation on how we can live our lives with the kind of environment that will allow us to grow. He says in verse 13, "Who is wise among you?" But before he lets them answer, he makes sure that they know he wasn't asking who was the smartest or who was the most intelligent. He was asking a bigger question. It wasn't who knew the most. It was a question of who was living right. Who was doing wisdom God's way? James goes on to write that it wasn't good deeds that would get us to the right kind of wisdom. It was living a good life, allowing our deeds to be done, but in humility. This word humility in the Greek actually means gentleness, but it's not the kind of gentleness that is passive or weak. It's the kind of gentleness that is strength under control. Like a horse that is trained under a bridle, this kind of humility means strength under control of the Spirit of God. Living a good life with this kind of humility is the kind of wisdom that we should strive for. And in the next two verses, James shows us what the wrong kind of wisdom, the human kind of wisdom, looks like. And he shows us that this kind of wisdom is worthless and no good. Let's read verse 14. It says, "But if you harbor bitter envy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not boast about it or deny the truth. Such wisdom does not come down from heaven, but it is earthly, unspiritual, and demonic. For where you have envy and selfish ambition, there you find disorder in every evil practice." See, earthly wisdom has a motive. And that motive is selfish gain. It's an attempt to elevate ourselves and as a result, reduce our dependence on God. But remember that James says, there's no way to talk yourself into wisdom or just to talk with your words into a place of wisdom. You must show your wisdom by living a good life. If you desire to be a person of wisdom, but you harbor bitterness and selfish ambition in your heart, verse 16 says you're way off course. It says such wisdom does not come down from heaven, but it's earthly, unspiritual, demonic. For where there's envy and selfishness, you find disorder in every evil practice. And I think it's easy for us to hear this and think to ourselves, I don't really engage in evil practices, so I must be doing okay. But did you know that in the Greek, that phrase has to do with participating in activities that are not fruitful and do not produce anything of benefit. What happens when we rely on earthly wisdom and selfish desires to get us by? We end up wasting our life. Wisdom that comes from heaven gives our life a purpose. Let's read verse 17. "But the wisdom that comes from heaven is first of all pure, then peace-loving, and considerate, submissive, full of mercy and good fruit, impartial and sincere. Wisdom that is pure is absent of selfish attitudes or motives. The right kind of wisdom loves peace. It's considerate of others. It's submissive to the will of God. When we strive to be people of God's kind of wisdom, we follow God's lead. It means that we're full of mercy. We listen more than we speak, and we're slow to become angry. We are impartial, meaning we don't show favoritism or discrimination, and we're genuine and sincere in our relationships and interactions with others. What's the goal? Let's read verse 18. It says, "Peacemakers who sow in peace will reap a harvest of righteousness." If the right conditions are critical to produce a great food harvest, how much more critical is it for us to produce a harvest of righteousness in our own lives? Raising a harvest of righteousness, though, demands a certain kind of climate. A crop of righteousness cannot be produced in the climate of bitterness and self-seeking. Righteousness will grow only in a climate of peace. And it must be sown and cultivated by us, the peacemakers. Such persons not only love peace, and they don't just live in peace, but they also strive to create conditions of peace. If you want wisdom, be a peacemaker, be loving, be full of mercy, and allow the fruit of your life to demonstrate that your wisdom comes from God and not from earthly things. Let's bow our heads and pray. God, we thank you that we learn what wisdom is and how we can walk in it from you. God, help us to turn away from the things of this world, the selfish ambition, the envy, the bitterness, and help us turn towards you, because it's only in you that we have a shot at your kind of wisdom. God, help us to be full of mercy, to be loving, to be compassionate, to pursue sincere and genuine relationships with others, to work to cultivate a climate where we can allow a harvest of righteousness and right living to grow within us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. Well, I hope that your life group conversation is fruitful and beneficial as you learn more about God's kind of wisdom. God bless you.